हेलो बंधुगण नमस्कार वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल साइज एजुकेशन एंड बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द टॉपिक आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक माय फ्रेंड्स दैट दे हैव सक्सेसफुली हेल्प्ड मी टू रीच 150 व्यूज एट लीस्ट इन विद इन 24 आवर्स एंड दे विल बी आस्किंग फॉर अ पार्टी नाउ सो एज प्रॉमिस्ड अर्लियर विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द आइसोमेरिज्म फर्स्ट विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम ऑप्टिकल आइसोमेरिज्म isomerism in monosaccharides. Whatever isomerism we are going to see here will be about the monosaccharides. Okay, when the term comes optical, it means you have to deal with some kind of light. Suppose, just take an example that you have some kind of monosaccharide, some monosaccharide solubilized in water. Just taking example as water as solvent. You have glucose solubilized in water and it is present in a tube. It is present in a tube. Very good. And a monochromatic light is going to pass through this tube. Monochromatic plain polarized light is going to pass through this. What is this monochromatic? It is about a single wavelength light, a light with single wavelength. Single wavelength light is going to pass through this tube which contains water and glucose as solute. Well, then what will happen with the light? If the light is going to turn around like clockwise direction, then this glucose present into the tube solubilized with water is dextrorotatory. It will be dextrorotatory. And if the light is being turned anti-clockwise direction, then it will be levorotatory. Levorotatory. This dextrorotatory will be denoted as small d or plus sign, and this levorotatory will be denoted as small l and minus sign. Okay, so hope you have understood the optical isomerism. Now the question comes, how this optical isomerism comes, how a single molecule is has two kind, that some kind of molecule is d glucose, some glucose is d glucose or l glucose. How this comes? Just take an example. Just take an example like glucose, or you can take also glyceraldehyde as example, the simplest monosaccharide. It will be D or L. Why? Depending upon these OH molecules present in the molecule. Actually, depending upon these OH groups, not molecules, depending upon the OH groups, hydroxyl groups, this molecule is going to be dextrorotatory or levorotatory. This is the basic fact. This is the basic concept behind any molecule's dextrorotation or levorotation. Moving forward, we have to learn about some chiral carbons in a molecule. What are these chiral carbons? Chiral carbons are also called as asymmetric carbons. First, learn about symmetry and asymmetry. I have written symmetric and asymmetric. Okay, symmetric. Just suppose we are going to draw heart and we'll cut this heart into two equal halves. You can easily say that half one is exactly same as half two. though the drawing here is not proper, I'm not an artist here. And if we draw a diagram like this, and we are going to cut this diagram into two equal halves, you can see here that there is 1, 2, 3, 4 bulgings in half 1, and in half 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 5 and half bulgings. So you can say that these two halves are not symmetric. That is why this is asymmetric. And this asymmetric also called as chiral. Is also called as chiral. So let's take an example of a molecule. A simple molecule, glyceraldehyde. Okay, in case of carbon, the asymmetric concept comes like this. You have already understood or learned in your lower classes, in your earlier classes, that carbon has four valency. That means carbon can bind or attach with four different kind of moieties, different kind of atoms at a single time. If the carbon is attached with X, Y, Z, ZA, then this is an asymmetric carbon or chiral carbon. This carbon is asymmetric or chiral. If the carbon is attached with X, Y, Z, and X again, then these two X's are present or bound with this single carbon. That is why this carbon is not going to be a chiral carbon. This is not a chiral carbon. This is a chiral carbon. This is asymmetric carbon. This is not asymmetric carbon. In the same way, if you see here in glyceraldehyde, you can see here that this carbon has a double bond. That means only three kind of moieties are attached with this carbon one. If we number this, okay, that means there is H at one hand, O with two hands, and this whole thing on the third hand. That is why this carbon 1, C1 is not chiral, is not asymmetric. What about carbon 2? What about carbon 2? You can see here, carbon 2 has this moiety at one hand, other contains hydroxyl group, and then hydrogen, and the fourth one contains this CH2OH group or moiety. So this carbon is asymmetric, is chiral carbon. What about the third one, C3 has two atoms of hydrogen in two hands. That is why again it is not going to be an asymmetric carbon or chiral carbon. Let's count some chiral carbon in glucose and fructose as well, because these kind of questions comes in your exams, that how many asymmetric or chiral carbons are present in glucose, how many asymmetric chiral carbons or chiral carbons are present in fructose. If we draw glucose here, this is Fischer projection. These crossings resemble with carbon. Definitely carbon 1 is not chiral, and carbon 6 is not chiral. What about these 4? Here OH is present at one hand, and on the other hand single carbon compound, that is CHO. Third hand has H only. And in the fourth hand, you can see carbon 1, 2, 3, 4. Four carbon moiety is present in the fourth hand. That is why it is going to be a chiral carbon. That means in glucose, chiral carbon C2. Then again coming to C3, carbon 3 it again has hydrogen in one hand. On the second hand, this two carbon containing compound or moiety. On the third hand, it contains OH. And in the fourth hand, it contains three carbon containing moiety. It is two carbon containing moiety. It is three carbon containing moiety. So it is again going to be a chiral carbon or asymmetric carbon. What about carbon 4? Then again, write it here that C3 is also a chiral carbon. What about C4? C4 again has OH at one hand, H in the second. This three carbon containing, 1, 2, 3. Three carbon moiety is here in the third hand. And in the fourth hand, this 1 and 2. Two carbon moiety. This is again going to be a chiral carbon. That is, C4 is again a chiral carbon or asymmetric carbon. What about the C5? C5 again contains OH. One at one hand. In the second hand, it has carbon 1, 2, 3, 4. Four carbon moiety. In the third hand, it contains only H. And in the fourth hand, it contains a molecule or a compound or a moiety, that is CH2OH. So it is again going to be a chiral carbon. I'm going to write it here that in case of glucose, you can see C2 to C5. That means 1, 2, 3 and 4 chiral carbons are present. Let's see the number of chiral carbons in fructose. Number of chiral carbons in fructose. CH2OH. Here, double bond O. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. CH2OH. OH, H, OH, H. H, OH. Okay. In case of fructose, this CH2OH, not a chiral carbon. This CH2OH, again this carbon is not going to be asymmetric or chiral. Then C2, it contains a double bond. Again, it has just stepped out from the chirality, or it is not again a chiral carbon. Then the left, C3, C4 and C5. These are the chiral carbons. In case of fructose, it is C3 to C5. That means number of chiral carbons are here 3. In case of glucose, it was 4. I hope you can count your chiral carbons in your molecules. Okay, one thing has been left here as optical activity. We have discussed about optical activity of a compound. Of a compound or molecule. Isn't it? That any kind of molecule is optically active when it is going to turn the light or monochromatic plane polarized light into clockwise direction or into anti-clockwise direction. This is clockwise, this is anti-clockwise. Clockwise or anti-clockwise direction, then it is going to be called as D or L respectively, and the compound is optically active. There are some compounds which are optically active, but they are not going to turn any kind of monochromatic light into towards the clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction. Why? Because they contain the number of hydroxyl groups just opposite into two sides of the compound. Just take an example. The compound is vitamin inositol. Vitamin inositol. Remember the name? Vitamin inositol. दिस इज विटामिन इनोसिटॉल और B8. What is this? Vitamin B8. If we draw its Fischer projection with various hydrolysis process, then we will see a structure. We'll see a structure like CH2OH. Again here CH2OH. OH, H, H, OH, H, H, OH. See, this is the Fischer projection after the hydrolysis of that vitamin inositol. You can see here two hydroxyl groups are present in the right side of this backbone and two hydroxyl groups are present in the left side of the backbone. That is why it just neutralizes the monochromatic light when it is going to turn it around anticlockwise direction. The other half, the other hydroxyl groups are not letting it to do this. If these hydroxyl are responsible to turn the monochromatic light into clockwise direction, then these hydroxyl groups will not allow to do this because they are going to turn this light in anticlockwise direction, and in resultant they are not going to turn the light in any direction. The light will pass through it in a straight line. So this is the optical activity and chiral carbons. Now we'll be moving towards the 3D structures. We'll be moving towards the 3D structures of a monosaccharide or of a compound. Generally, we are studying here monosaccharides, though that is why we'll discuss about the monosaccharides only here. 3D structures can be seen in two different forms. One is Fischer projection, and another one is Haworth projection. One is Fischer projection and another one is Haworth projection. Fischer projection has different characteristics and Haworth projections have different characteristics. In case of Fischer projection, it is open chain. It is open chain structure of a compound. Okay. Number two. This open chain structures may have the hydroxyl groups and hydrogen atoms just horizontal. That is, if this backbone, if the backbone is like this, vertical, then hydrogen and hydroxyl group will lie horizontally upon this backbone. Okay. And point three, another characteristic is, this hydroxyl group and hydrogen atom may be changed in 180 degree direction. May be changed or may be rotated in exactly 180 degree direction angle. If we rotate it in 90 degree angle, then it will be another isomer of that compound. So if you gonna just invert the thing, then you have to invert it in 180 degree angle. If, just take an example, if we write OH here and H here, we're gonna change this thing. We'll be writing H here and OH here. These two things are same. There is nothing to worry. So Fischer projection, in case of Fischer projection, it is open chain structures. Hydroxyl groups are attached in horizontal direction and carbons are attached with each other in vertical direction. So these are the characteristics of Fischer projection. Now coming to the Haworth projection. If If we see the Haworth projection, it has also some kind of characteristics that it is a closed structure. That is ring form, ring-like structure. Definitely, you have seen the structure of glucose in Wikipedia or in any website of the internet. That glucose is shown like this. Like this. This is the Haworth projection. This is the closed ring-like structure. Okay. Characteristic number two. The second characteristic about Haworth projection that the position of OH or H, position of OH or H will depend upon the Fischer projection. If this Fischer projection has OH in the right side, then in case of Haworth projection, it is going towards down. If this Fischer projection has the moiety or atom in the right side of the backbone, then this Haworth projection is going to have that molecule, moiety or atom in the downwards. Downwards means what? This is a plane. This is going to be a plane. And OH is attached with it like this. And the moieties or atoms writing above this plane, it is going to direct towards you. It is directing towards the viewer. So it is clear. Is it clear to you? If this Fischer Haworth projection has H and OH like this, then H is towards you and OH is towards the downward. It is just downwards of the plane. The plane. This is going to be a planar structure. Haworth projection is a planar structure in which the OH and H are directing upward or downward. So these are the characteristics of Haworth projection. And one more thing, that Haworth projection is the standard projection that is being used nowadays in our textbooks or in regular activities. Anywhere, wherever you go, you will work with Haworth projection, not with the Fischer projection. Now, dividing this Haworth projection, or if we see this Haworth projection more carefully, then we will see Haworth projection. We will see that it is being divided into two forms, or there are two kind of structures, two kind of rings. One is pyranose and another one is furanose. Pyranose looks like pyran and furanose looks like furan. We'll be discussing about these structures in our later part of the series in the next video. So that's all for this video, and thank you very much. Enjoy learning.